Hello aspirants, welcome to Visham IAS Academy. History class 6th NCERT. First 4 chapters nammal complete edu. Chapter 5th, the topic is what books and Burial tell us. And the subtopic first one is Vedas. It is one of the oldest books of the world, that is Vedas. Nalana undu, that is Rigveda, Samaveda, Yajurveda, Atharva Veda. The oldest Veda is Rigveda. It composed about 3500 years ago. The Rigveda includes more than 1000 hymns. That hymns is called Sukta or well said. So, 3 points ஒத்துக்கணும். 4 Vedas and the oldest Veda is Rigveda. And it includes hymns and it composed about 3500 years ago. These hymns are in praise of various gods and goddesses. 3 gods are especially important. That is Agni. We all know that Agni is the god of fire, Indra, a warrior or god, and Soma, a plant from which a special drink was prepared. These hymns were composed by sages, that is rishis, priests, taught students to recite and memorize each syllable, word and sentence bit by bit with great care. Most of the hymns were composed, taught and learned by men. A few were composed by women. The Rigveda is in old or Vedic Sanskrit. The Rigvedas was recited and heard rather than read it. It was written down several centuries after it was first composed and printed less than 200 years ago. Next is archaeology study of Vedas. Some of the hymns in the Rigveda are in the form of dialogues. This is part of one such hymn, a dialogue between a sage named Vishwamitra and 2 rivers, that is Bees and Satluj, that were worshipped as goddesses. And next point is there are many prayers in Rigveda for cattle, children, especially sons and horses. Horses were yoked to chariots that were used in battles, which were fought to capture cattle. Battles were also fought for land, which was important for pasture and for growing hardy crops that ripened quickly and such as barley. Some battles were fought for water and to capture people. Some of the wealth that was obtained was kept by leaders, some was given to the priest and the rest was distributed amongst the people. Some wealth was used for the performance of yajnas or sacrifices in which offerings were made into the fire. These were meant for gods and goddesses. നമ്മൾ എപ്പിക്സിലൊക്കെ നമ്മൾ യജ്ഞനെ കുറിച്ച് കണ്ടിട്ടുണ്ടാവും. അതാണ് അവിടെ മെൻഷൻ ചെയ്യുന്നത്. ഓഫറിങ്സ് കുഡ് ഇൻക്ലൂഡ് ഗീ, ഗ്രെയിൻ ആൻഡ് ഇൻ സം കേസസ് അനിമൽസ്. മോസ്റ്റ് മെൻ ടുക്ക് പാർട്ട് ഇൻ ദീസ് വാർസ്. There was no regular army, but there was assemblies where people met and discussed matters of war and peace. They also chose leaders who were often brave and skillful warriors. There are 2 groups who are described in terms of their work, that is the priests, sometimes called Brahmins, who performed various rituals, and Rajas. These Rajas were not like the ones who will be learning about later. They did not have capital cities, palaces or armies, nor did they collect taxes. The capital cities undavilla, palaces undavilla, taxes um collect cheyilla. Sons did not automatically succeed fathers as Rajas. Next, 2 words were used to describe the people or the community as a whole. One was the word Jana, which we still use in Hindi and other languages. The other was Vish. But 2 words say again, Jana and Vish. The word Vaishya comes from Vish. The people who composed the hymns described themselves as Aryans and called their opponents Dasas or Dasyus. Appa Aryans and Dasas in Kurushana mentioned Jaina. These were people who did not perform sacrifices, that is Yajnas, and probably spoke different languages. Later, the term Dasa, that is the feminine Dasis, came to mean slave. So, ഇവിടെ പറയുന്നത് ദാസ ദാസിയാണ്. Slaves were women and men who were often captured in war. They were treated as the property of their owners, who could make them do whatever work they wanted. Rig Veda was being composed in northwest of the subcontinent. There were other developments elsewhere. Next is megalith. These are the stone boulders are known as megalith, that is literally big stones. These were carefully arranged by people and were used to mark burial sites. Upper megaliths used for or used to mark burial sites. The practice of erecting megaliths began about 3000 years ago and was prevalent throughout the Deccan, South India, the Northeast and Kashmir. Some megaliths can be seen on the surface, other megalith burials are often underground. Appo surface ilum underground ilum megaliths kaanunnunde kaanapettirunnu. Archaeologists find a circle of stone boulders or a single large stone standing on the ground. These are the only indications that there are burials beneath. All these burials have some common features. The dead were buried with distinctive pots, which are called black and red ware. Also found are tools and weapons of iron and sometimes skeletons of horses, horse equipment and ornaments of stone and gold. Among various burials, one skeleton was buried with 33 gold beads, 2 stone beads, 4 copper bangles and 1 conch shell. Other skeletons have only a few ports. These finds suggest that there was some difference in status amongst the people who were buried. Some were rich, others poor, some chiefs and others followers. At Inamkaun site, that is a burial site, it was occupied between 3600 and 2700 years ago. Here adults were generally buried in the ground, laid out straight with the head towards the north, and sometimes burials were within the houses. Vessels that probably contained food and water were placed within the dead. One man was found buried in a large four-legged clay jar in the courtyard of a five-roomed house, that is one of the largest houses at the site, in the center of the settlement. This house also had a granary. The body was placed in a cross-legged position. Next is miscellaneous things found. Also found that the seeds of wheat, barley, rice, pulses, millets, peas and sesame, bones of a number of animals, many bearing cut marks that show that they may have been used as food, have also been found. These include cattle, buffalo, goat, sheep, dog, horse, ass, pig, sambar, spotted deer, black buck, antelope, hare and mongoose, besides birds, crocodile, turtle, crab and fish. There is evidence that fruits such as ber, amla, jamun, dates and a variety of berries were collected. So these are the miscellaneous things that found in the burial section. Next chapter is 6th chapter, Kingdoms, King and Earlier Republics. We will see that in next video. Thank you.